What's going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. Today it's the return of the iPhone 7 in jet black, which hasn't got a scratch on it, by the way. No scratches. So today we're going to do the review 1 month later with the iPhone 7. Let's get started. So if you haven't seen it yet, we've done the 2 month later video with the iPhone 7 Plus. If you haven't checked that out, I'll leave it on a card at the end. Also in the description down below for you to check it out. But today we're taking a look at the iPhone 7 and basically a little review on what I've noticed so far. So again, basically the same thing with the iPhone 7 was that I started off with the matte black iPhone 7. It wasn't the one I wanted, again, as I wanted the jet black. As you know, it's different. It's going back to its, not so much its roots, but when the 3 came out, you know, it had this same sort of similar shininess. But it did scratch quite easily, I'll tell you that now, as well as what they've said about this one. Now, this one has lived in a case all its life. Since I've had it, it's been in either the battery case or the silicone case, hence why it's probably no scratches on it, as it doesn't really come out. It only comes out every now and again, and it doesn't go in a pocket with anything else besides just itself, really. But obviously with the jet black, you've got to be so careful. You've got to make sure that nothing's touching the phone. If anything touches it in the slightest, you are going to get hairline scratches. And from what we've been told, there is stuff out there which you may be able to get them out, but who knows whether it works or not without doing the actual full test ourselves. And to be honest with you, with this having nothing on it at all, I don't think I'm going to take that chance. But jumping into the review, I'll tell you now, we'll start off with the battery and then work our way through it. So battery life on this, again, is going back to the way the 6S used to be. Now obviously I had quite a few 6S's during last year, and I opted to go and get the 7, which I wasn't going to do. I was just going to keep hold of my rose gold 6S, but then I decided, no, let's go for the 7. I'm glad I did it. It does last me a little bit longer than what the 6S used to. However, I still have to find the battery case for it. So I ended up picking up this while I was in America. It is, of course, the iPhone 7 battery case. Looks just like the 6S one. If you haven't checked out this video, I'll leave that at the end too, so you can check that out. But constantly, every day, no matter what, I always find myself reaching for this case to put this phone into to give it an extra bit of juice, because it doesn't last out the day. If you're out and about, this ain't gonna last you. But I have got portable battery banks from the likes of Anker and stuff like that, so I try and use them rather than go for the battery case. But 9 times out of 10, I'm just gonna reach for the battery case, put it in, and away I go. I'm back charging, and the phone's still ready to use. Now, obviously, with it having iOS 10 on it, I never done the beta version like I did with the Plus. I just stayed with the normal everyday software. So it's currently up to date. At the moment it's on 10.1.1, I believe. The software does actually make this phone really, really good. But again, it's probably just the same as having the 6S and getting a wrap, basically, to put on the back. But yeah. Now the camera, again, is where this phone's gonna shine. I'll insert some pictures now. As you can see from the pictures, it does a really good job. It's really fast at focusing. It's pretty good during low light shots. Not as good as the Google Pixel, but it is good. It is really good. But it's still not as good as the iPhone 7 Plus, its bigger brother, with having that big, massive dual lens camera. Now again, we're going back to the same sort of style as the iPhone 7 Plus, with obviously the no physical home button. It's the Taptic Engine underneath it with a glass panel on top of it, so it's just the same as its bigger brother in that part. The body style is exactly the same. The matte black and the gloss black hide the antenna lines perfectly well. No headphone jack, as you just see. No headphone jack, you know, as we all know, but again, not something that's going to affect me, as either if I'm in the car I'm using Bluetooth, or I've actually got a lightning cable in the car. I just plug it in, it charges and plays the music as well. so it doesn't really affect me in that way. When I'm at the gym, etc., I tend to use just the Lightning headphones that came with the phone. I am looking into some Bluetooth ones, maybe the Jaybirds, so maybe there'll be a review coming on them very shortly. I'm not going to go for Apple's earpods. I was going to, but I've decided, no, it's not for me. So there's that. So don't forget that. It's all got to be through Bluetooth or the Lightning port on the bottom. So everyone, and as you know, it's also got the water resistance now. Not fully waterproof, water resistance, but obviously there are tests out there that have been done which show it underwater for a long period of time and still working. But that's up to you whether you want to take that chance or not. But guys, thanks very much for watching as always. Obviously I'll leave all the links and stuff like that in the description down below, and links to previous videos that I've done with the iPhone 7 or the 7 Plus one that I've done a couple of weeks ago. But thanks very much for watching guys as always. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe for more videos to come, and as always guys, I will see you in the next one. Take care everyone.